Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2012 biographical historical drama film called, Lincoln. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy the video. The movie starts showing a scenery of war, violence, and bloodshed. It was the flashback of a black man soldier that is talking to President Lincoln. The black men are telling the president the hardship of black men in military, and the possible rights that may happen to them. While they are talking, white soldier men suddenly appeared, and talk to the president. They pronounce the Gettysburg Address the president stated but are later on called by their commanders to come to their companies. 2 months have passed after President Lincoln's re-election, the American was as in its fourth year. Lincoln is telling his wife his dream about a ship moving by some terrible power and speed. Molly is shaky about his dream. After complaining about the carriage accident, she suddenly thought about what the dream about ships signifies. It was about the amendment to abolish slavery. She discouraged Lincoln about the amendment. She thought that it was sure to fail. The next day, Lincoln gave a short speech about flag raising. After that, in a carriage, they are discussing about the voting of the amendment. There are still 20 votes lacking. The secretary argued that the amendment is not needed since they will win the war. There is no need to go to the House to discuss about the amendment with the same people who rejected that 10 months ago. But Lincoln is feeling positive about the chances of winning in the current situation. In their office, they are strategizing about how they can gain the 20 vote to win the amendment. Suddenly, Mr. and Mrs. Jolly came for the right of toll booth they are able to possess from his grandfather. Then, Mrs. Jolly was asked by the man about the 13th Amendment, and she favored it. She thought that the war will end if the slavery has ended. However, the man asked again if the war finished first before they are able to end the slavery, assuming that the South is exhausted of their resources, would they still want to vote for the amendment? She said that should not vote because they prefer that they want to keep their properties and jobs to themselves. Abraham asked them to leave and come back in the morning to consider about what the law said about their situation. In another place, Lincoln is talking with Preston asking the Republicans to vote for the amendment. However, one man asked about what they get for doing so. Vulgar words are said, which the woman besides them asked them to stop because a child is sitting there with them. Attention is turned to Lincoln's son. The old man is talking to him asking about his brother, and about what they want for all the help they give to his father. He said that the Republican are not abolitionists, they can't tell them to vote yes unless Lincoln is to say that he is seeking a negotiated peace. In the office, men are talking about the strategy to end war quickly by bombarding using the largest fleet to target the Fort Fisher, and execute a steady barrage till they surrender. If Wellington fall, the Richmond follows which will allow them to secure victory and the war is done. Then a man complained why they are not turning the nation attention to the war, but instead to the anti-slavery amendment that is being precipitated into the House floor for debate. Lincoln argues that he wants the amendment through the House to prevent another act of slavery to happen if ever the war ends, and that he no longer holds any power to set them free. That is why he wanted it to be established as soon as possible, and wanted their support like they always did. After the meeting, Lincoln met with Mr. Representative Ashley to talk about bringing the 13th Amendment to the floor for debate. The secretary told him that they are expecting their full support about the matter, but Mr. Representative said no, since they cannot organize anything immediately in the House. Lincoln, however, is able to convince him. In the court, on January 9th, the House debate begins. The floor is given to Mr. Woods, who will speak against the passing of the amendment. He argues that it will indeed set immediate liberty on the colored population, but will cause them to lose millions of dollars, and it will manacle the limbs on the white race of America. His speech gave clamors among the men who are on his side, while amongst form the other side. Statements that attack the speaker are made. However, Mr. Woods still argues, about the natural law, that those created by God unequal should Congress must never declare equal. This man surely thinks that God love white people only. The pro side answered that the only insult to natural law is slavery. The first debate ended there. The older son of Lincoln is at the mansion to visit. Molly is very happy to see his son. At night, the Preston is talking to Lincoln. He said that he had visited Richmond to talk to the traitors and plead. He gave the names of the three delegates to be sent so that Lincoln could talk peace with them. It will be spring in 2 months, which means that the roads will be passable, and that the bloodshed will commence for the fourth time when the time comes. He is rushing Lincoln to talk to these people to stop the war from killing more of their sons. Days goes by, they are trying to convince the Democrats into voting yes for the amendments for making up to the 20 lacking votes. In the end, they are able to get 7 yeses from Mr. Ellis, they still need to get 13 more. After that, Lincoln's secretary talked to him about the revolving rumor that he had allowed Preston Blair to go to Richmond to invite Jeff David to send commissioners to Washington to come up with a peace plan. The secretary asked him in hopes that he didn't. However, on no man's land, January 11th, Lincoln did send a reactionary dotard. The secretary is mad about this decision. This can be turned against the president because he can be questioned why they need to enrage the Confederacy over the issue of slavery when they are here to make peace. The secretary insists that it is either the amendment or the Confederate peace. If Republicans and Democrats will ever talk to them about the peace, their efforts will be wasted. Lincoln only insists that the secretary should get him 13 votes before they arrive. In a room, Lincoln and his son, Robbie, is arguing because he wants to join the military, but his father refuses to enlist him. In a bedroom, Molly is crying about the party. This reminded her of her deceased son. Lincoln tried to comfort him then. On the party, it was as if she didn't cry when she displays her smile to the guests. She then met Steve, and argued, and berated him about the accounting of their household, and the achievements of his husband is how people love him very much. In the basement, Lincoln is talking to Mr. Steve about the debate, and asked him to temper his contribution to at least not frighten the other conservatives. Steve argued that when the war ends, he intends to push for full equality where the Negroes can vote and other possibilities. Confiscated properties will be used as the fund source of the improvement, and will help assist on establishing freedom to all. Lincoln, although very admiring of his ambitions, he had counter-argued that their goal right now will fail. He wanted to insist that they should see what they walk other than where they want to go to. At night in their bedroom, Molly is convincing Lincoln not to recruit Robbie to the military. She is afraid that she will lose her son again if he ever joins the military. Their argument was halted with a knock, and Lincoln left urgently. On the second day of the House debate, the floor was given to Mr. George Eman. He had announced that he is against the amendment although disgusted by slavery. He argued about what might happen if 4 million colored men are set free in one instant. Instant reply was said by the pro side stating that they will be free, and that's what will become of them. Mr. Yeaman continues that white people will be forced to give them the right to vote as it would be inhuman not to. He instigated the crowd by questioning them as to whether they want the colored people to vote. If it possibly happened, another possibility that the vote is right to be given to the women too. His statements have successfully incited a reaction from every man in the room. The second debate ended there. The vote for the amendment was reduced from 12 to 11. Words were spread to people that there is a Confederation peace going around, and it is being questioned. The Chief General of the United States Army have successfully made the Confederate peace commissioners, and the worry of the Secretary of the State is now removed. House of Representatives, January 27th, the third House debate commenced. There, Stevens is being told to speak about believing only about the legal equality for all races instead of racial equality. Steve was interrogated there then. He is asked whether he had literally taken that all men are created equally. Stevens then answered that the true purpose of the amendment is that to allow equality of all things before the law, and nothing more. He then explained that even a white man who has committed a crime will be treated equally before the law. His statement got a mixed reaction from the crowds, some are silenced by the thought while some still opposes. After the debate, Asa confronted Stevens for his statement. Asa had taken Stevens' statement negatively, and understood that Stevens denied every Negroes their right. Stevens then explains that he wants the amendment to pass so that the Constitution's first and only mention of slavery is its prohibition. Next day, Robbie and Lincoln went to a hospital. Robbie refused to go in thinking that their affair there was for his father to discourage him from going to army by seeing injuries. While Lincoln went inside to talk to some people, Robbie saw someone pushing a cart with blood dripping from it. He followed them to where they are going, and there he witnessed severed arms and feet. This gave him a scare. When Lincoln went out, Robbie confronted him about joining military, to which he insists that he must. Lincoln, however, disagrees and they argued. The son said that Lincoln is not afraid of him dying but is afraid of his mama. Lincoln slapped his son for this answer but still insists that he enters military or else he will feel ashamed of himself for the rest of his life. At night, in the couple's bedroom, Lincoln tries to convince Molly to let their son join the military. Molly does not agree. She is afraid that the war will kill their son. She screamed at Lincoln for this decision and broke down. Lincoln told Molly that he could not tolerate her for grieving for Willie so much because he couldn't permit it himself, though he wanted to. Lincoln in the end walks away. Next day, at night, Lincoln talked to Mrs. Keckley. A talk about what freedom is, and what it might bring was talked about. Negroes have been fighting and dying for freedom. Since they have not experienced freedom, they have no idea what freedom might bring. 4 days before the voting, Lincoln visited Mr. Bilbo, and the others to ask for a favor. He told them to visit the Democrats they know into agreeing to vote for the amendment. The rest of the 4 days are used to threaten or convince the others into voting for yes. In a room, Lincoln is talking to Preston and other Republicans. They are angry to Lincoln for denying them peace commissioners. Their chance of ruin the abolition amendment and leave the Constitution alone was lost. With them speaking at the same time, Lincoln in the end got angry. He said that unless we cure them of slavery and end the war, they cannot talk about the human meaning or worth. The amendment is the cure to all this chaos happening now and in the future. On the morning of the vote, January 31, 1865, black people have attended the event. Mr. Ashley was given the floor to make a speech. After that, he gave the floor to Honorable George Pendleton, and there, he presented to everyone affidavits of testify of the commissioners have indeed come there, to bear an offer of cessation of war. This sparked a reaction on the people, and they insisted to postpone the vote. There someone seconded the motion to postponing. Mr. Bilbo, and ran to the mansion to inform the president of the matter with a note. Mr. President replied in the note that there is no commissioner of peace. He asked that they deliver that back to Mr. Alley too, and voting continued. Voting is taken from the representatives one by one. The vote is being announced to everyone outside the court too, and even the speaker has voted yes. In the end, the final vote, 8 absent, 56 votes against, 119 votes for, the amendment have been established with only a margin of 2 votes. Everyone has celebrated, especially the black people, for gaining their freedom and establishing peace. Singing and loud music are being played everywhere. Mr. Stevens have asked to take the amendment and return it tomorrow. In the evening, Mr. Stevens gave the bill to his lover, to which gave her so much happiness. The next day, Lincoln discussed with the rebels people about the surrender. Return to the laws and guarantees of rights and immediate freedom are being discussed. The slavery is done and rights are given to everyone, and all will be considered citizens. As they are passing through the battlefield, dead bodies can be seen everywhere. Smoke and a gloomy atmosphere surround the area. In the office talking about the Negroes voting, Lincoln is reminded that he need to pick up Miss Harris and Major Rathbone. In the theater, it was announced suddenly that the president had been shot. President Lincoln didn't survive the shot and died at 7:22 in the morning of April 15, Saturday. Cries are hears. And the flashback of his speech is seen. Though he had successfully established the amendment, he was not able to see guide his country in recovering from the previous chaos. In the end, he was still able to aim and achieve the greater good for all of his citizens. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.